Hi, my name is Harry Dill. I'm a 70-year-old newly minted CFI and operate a modest flight school called Alicat Aviators. Alicat trains pilots seeking tailwheel endorsements and also provides light aerobatic and spin training. The training aircraft is a 1975 Blanca Decathlon Model 8 KCAB. It has 150 horsepower Lycoming engine driving a constant speed prop and has fully inverted fuel and oil systems. This is my daughter Sarah Maynard. She is a senior FO with Frontier Airlines and flies Airbus A320s and A321s. Sarah is no stranger to tailwheel aircraft. She received her private pilot at a young age in a Super Cub and built hours towards regional airlines by towing banners in highly modified Super Cubs. It's been 18 years since Sarah flew a tail dragger. Today's mission is to shake some rust off her tailwheel skills. The lesson plan today is to climb to 3,000, do a couple stalls, we'll do some steep turns. We want Sarah to get a feel for the control response on this particular airplane. Following that, we will head over to Siler City. It is a paved strip that rarely has much traffic, so we should be able to do some pattern work there without too much interference. But first we'll stop for a run-up. Sarah has the controls as we taxi to runway 21 here at the Duchy. At that point, I'll take over. My agreement with our homeowners association is that I'm pilot flying on all takeoffs and landings when instructing out of the Duchy. Sarah has the controls, and we're approaching 3,000 feet. Since we're already in a climb configuration, I've asked her to go ahead and do a power-on stall. Notice how she incrementally pulls the nose up instead of a smooth pullback. Now, I thought she reduced the angle of attack a little bit too much there. We lost a little more altitude than to, so I've asked her to do it again, but do the recovery a little bit earlier. A lot smoother here. We'll have a break. There it goes, and much better. Didn't lose quite so much altitude that time. Next, I asked Sarah to do a 360-degree turn to the left, and followed immediately by a 360-degree turn to the right, with a 45-degree bank angle. Found this interesting in that she's very smooth on the controls, does a nice job, but she lost 500 feet, and I can't help but wonder if that isn't a carryover from the A320. It has a fly-by-wire flight control system that automatically compensates for altitude loss in a turn by automatically cranking in some elevator. In a light plane like this, it is the pilot that has to crank in some elevator to avoid altitude loss. I have the controls here. I just wanted to demonstrate to Sarah how much elevator is really needed when you do these deep turns. So we roll into about a 60 degree bank here, and I'm pulling so hard, you see her pointing out there's a stall warning light in the cockpit that is going on and off. We're very close to stall here. It's an accelerated stall because we're pulling about 2 G's at this point. Unfortunately, I rolled out earlier, so she's pointing out that my stop reference point on the turn is over here. So we get there, and then we immediately roll it to the right 60-degree bank and do our 360 degrees in that direction. Next, I have Sarah do a power-off stall. Sarah has the controls here, and we are in the pattern at Siler City. This is our first pass over the runway. We're going to do a low pass, and I just want to see how she handles this approach. We're pretty far away from the runway on the downwind. No surprise. As we make the turn here, we're getting pretty low. There is no way we would make the field if there was an engine failure. I'm sure this is all perspective. Things look a lot different from the cockpit or the decathlon than they do from an A320. She does a real good job with a low pass here. We might be a little fast, but I think she did a really good job here with perspective as far as how high we are above the runway. I want to show Sarah what it should look like from the front seat of the decathlon on approach into the airport, so I do the next one. Another low pass by Sarah. This one's perfectly executed. Okay, Sarah's going to land it this time. First try in 18 years, we'll see how it goes. I want you to watch very carefully the nose of the aircraft. Watch how the pitch oscillates before she touches down. You see the nose go up, go down, go up, go down. I'm noticing in the back seat the stick is moving forward an inch or two, back an inch or two, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. And when we touch down, comes forward on the stick like it's a wheel landing. Now what I'm looking for here is a constant pitch, and we just use power if we need to set the aircraft on the runway. So I've explained this to her, and we're going to go around for another try. Okay, second try. Let's see how this goes. And we're still going back and forth on that elevator a little bit. But we're getting there. The attitude of touchdown is good. Very good. So let's go around and try again. We're closing in on it. I have a good feeling about this next one coming up. Beautiful. They do not get better than that. That's two in a row. Must not be a fluke. Let's try one more before we head back home. That's one proud daddy in the back seat. When it comes to flying, my daughter is a natural. Outstanding stick. Per HOA agreement, I have the controls. What a magic day for daddy in the back.